So last weekend, I got a flat as shit. I just picked up these black label Tioga's as well. I've been running the React X or whatever they are and been blowing too many of them out. So I got these black labels, meant to be way better. And I was literally, we finished our session, I was standing there talking to Levi, telling him how good these ties are, and then pew, straight flat. So quickly change this, hit some sprints with the bro, and then we rest up for practice Friday because it's race week. So being race week, the jump on the rollers, what is this, Tuesday today, practice is until Friday, so get some spins out on the rollers, some high RPM stuff, hit some sprints in the street, keep the legs firing, and we pretty much chill out till practice Friday, and then big weekend of racing.
Yeah, I literally spent all my time in the park. Is my food in the freezer?
Yes, it's in the freezer.
Are you recording
There's
me?
No more room for anything else in the freezer.
Fuck yeah!
Hey, bleep that out.
You actually recording?
Oh my god!
Hey guys.
Welcome back to my channel.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to show you how Bodie and Wade train for the big day.
She's black now.
I needed some shit with some bub in it. Top one again, alright?
Hey everyone, so. Just filming. This is what we do. Don't tell him I missed that.
Is it filming right now?
Yeah.
Just do it again.
It turned off.
You turned it off.
Hello. So Bodie, tell me about your day.
YouTube accent gets
me
every time.
That's all I know. Oh. Oh.
wraps up a sprint sesh, last minute sprint sesh, a couple days of chill, practice time, it's go time on Friday. Yew! Just getting to the track. Our practice is 12 o'clock, it's about 39 degrees. It's gonna be a brutal day, but obviously hit a few laps of the track already. Know the track pretty well, so I won't do too many laps. So just get smooth, get comfortable, fire the legs off, and then go back and chill out, ready for racing tomorrow.
Yeah, Maxi! Were you in that Paco?
Yeah.
How was it?
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah? Hot out there? How's the tyres? 110 or what?
No, I forgot about them actually.
Oh.
On the hill, just, you know when you just like,
yeah, yeah. Oh, ooh.
No, I only feel better next week. Or tomorrow, whenever it is.
How's the pit tent set up?
Love them.
Every country, every team. Damn, BMX A's over here. Alright, got to the track. Little interview with BMX Ultra ECI, Shane Jenko. It was quick, it was like a sauna under that tent. I was absolutely dripping in sweat. I've got half an hour, it's 11:30, I've got half an hour till I'm on the track. Group A is on the track at the moment, all those top ranked guys. I did shit all last year, so that's why I'm in Group B. But hey, hopefully there's some space on the track to put in some hot laps and then get a couple practice wins in the first turn. And then come back and chill out. Finished up a bit of Paco with the boy in that Rodway. How'd you go, mate?
Got smoked, nearly died a few times.
I've seen that second straight, bit gnarly.
Yeah.
Did you hit a third as well?
I didn't crash this time in first lap practice. So
there you go.
I'd take
that as a win.
Yeah, I didn't fly that first corner either. So.
Did you get a heat race win into the turn or what?
No, not me. Just to the first jump this time.
Oh, well, that's fair, that's enough. How about the race?
What's that?
How was the practice, mate?
Good, I got heat exhaustion.
Yeah.
Got smoked out of the gate.
No.
Not in.
No?
Yeah. But it's fun. It was fun out there.
Yeah, nice. Getting steezy down the second straight.
Oh, I don't know about steezy.
Triple to manual into the first turn.
Yeah.
Every quad. Time. Every time. Quad.
Sometimes I go manual triple.
Ooh.
Hop off the back wheel.
Sneaky. You would
straight
too.
Over the whole thing.
Yeah. Very nice.
Yep. I learnt that off Bodie Turner.
Oh, I don't know. He might have done that unintentionally.
Ever heard of her?
Who?
Who?
good luck.
Thanks, bro.
Lineup for the next one. Heat number 8, Chirard, Kloshenko, Krasevskis, Dubois, Shimada, Bodie Turner. Nice to see him back. Matthew Tidswell and Hashimoto, I think it was. Heat number 8 on the way. All the power on the inside with Corbin Chirard, and it looks like the Russian rider Kloshenko got cut off a little bit, so he's back there in 4 at the moment as they head towards the turn. One rider's gone down on the first straight. We'll give you an idea on that one soon, but it's Chirard leading it out. He's looking good at the moment. Kloshenko working his way up into 4, but Chirard leading it through. Krasevsky's in there in 2. That's Bodie Turner in there in 3. The 7-4-7 flying like a jumbo jet down that third straight, in and out the final turn. Corbin Chirard took some wins at Rock Hill last year. He's going to get it. Krasevsky's in 2, Turner in 3, Kloshenko in 4.
We're going to head back up to the hill for heat number 11. Bodie Turner, Pillard, Heil, Carnes, Webster, Rosa, Boynton, and Mitchell Schottman. sprinters, both of Australia and from the Netherlands, it's Mitchell Schottmann. Best four riders from each heat qualify for the eighth finals.
Set!
Okay, riders, let them start. Riders ready, watch the gate.
747, a Bodie Turner off to a late start coming out of lane one, but he should be okay if he manages to hold on to his position and take advantage of being on the inside. So it's going to be Turner finding himself stuck back, relegated into fourth place, battling it out with the German rider. It's going to be Arthur Pillard taking it to the front. I believe Rosa Akarns in second and Turner Webster in fourth. So Turner finding himself into third place, Pillard with a nice lead in first, and Karns, the French rider, bringing it on home for the win in this lap, followed by Karns, Turner, and Webster.
Yeah, really nice to see Bodie Turner back on track, back on the World Cup scene, working his way through to those eighth finals. That's the kind of return you want, and there is the official result. Pillard, Karns, Turner, and Webster all going through. Mitchell Schottmann out in seven, Shane Rosa out in eight.
Next up, we have Pelluard, Maye, Turner, Freiswick, Smith, Nagasako, Bernhardt, and Molina.
Nagisaka
Bernhardt from Chile, it's Molina Vergara, and from Australia, Corey
Frischbay.
We're official. Vincent Pelluard in lane one. Down the gate they go. Looks like Smith straight to the front. Pelluard looks like he's looking for that second place position. Maye going from third to almost second place. Looks like he's going to do that. Throws his weight around. Finds himself in second place. Nagasako in third. But Smith running away with it, or looking to run away with it. Smith, Maye, Nagasako, and Molina. 1, 2, 3, and 4 going into the last corner. We'll see what happens, as fourth place is never safe in single elimination. There's a wreck in the last corner. Not sure who's going to make it out of that. I think Pelluard might be the person to pick it up. Smith, Maye, Nagasako, and Pelluard.
Yeah, Bodie Turner was trying to make it happen in that final turn, and there was a coming together. You know, riders hitting the floor. I think it was Molina. And on the 181, Turner just ended up fifth. Here we go. Lucky went down. That led to the Colombian rider getting in there. That was Vincent Pelluard. He benefited from that particular piece of action. And you can see Turner shaking his head as he came across the line. Smith, Maye, Nagasako, and Pelluard. Confirmed as going through to the quarterfinals. The lap from James Palmer. Obviously, he took a tumble in round one, so we'll be looking for better today. Nagasako, Turner, Gargaglia, Shippers, Heil, Amidou Mir, Kate Stindl, and Tony Sirafudin, I think that is, from Indonesia. This is heat number five. Sorry, heat number six, I do apologise. And lane number two sees the return of Bodie Turner on the 747. Will he be flying like a jumbo jet into turn number one? We are soon going to see he's on the inside. It looks like he might pick up the whole shot. Yeah, Turner out front looking very, very good at the moment. That looks like Nagasako in there in three at the minute, just trying to pick up the rider in two. But Bodie Turner absolutely flying in this one. It's Stefan Heil in there in two. Nagasako in three. Amidou Mir in four. But Bodie Turner, the Aussie favourite, in and out the final corner. He's going to pick up a moto win. That'll do wonders for his confidence. Bodie Turner crossing the line first. Nagasako and Heil battling for that second spot. Amidou Mir in four. Kay Stindl and everybody else on the way to the LC.
This happened right here with this group on the gate. See Bodie Turner, the 747, bouncing up and down with those blue pants on. 16th finals, men's elite coming up. Right on top of the hill, as you can see there. Fourth or better will get them into the eighth finals. We are in single elimination, so from here on out, if the rider does not get fourth or better, they are done for the day. Heat one, 16th finals lead men, Mayhew, Turner, Schmidt, Racine, Nagasako, Seegers, Boynton, and Rodway. Bodie Turner, lane one, white helmet. He has returned to international racing. I'm sorry, not lane one, lane two. Romain Mayhew from France in lane one. We're official. Down the gate they go. Looks like someone doesn't get a good start. He'll be coming out. He has some work cut ahead of him. It's going to be Mayhew straight to the front with a pretty good lead. Looks like Turner's finding himself in third behind Nagasako. Nagasako having a great round one, wanting to improve upon that for round two today. So hopping into the second corner, sun shining bright. Mayhew, Nagasako, Turner, and Racine. Racine in fourth place. We'll see if he can hold on to that. Looks like there's a bit of space between fourth and fifth, but you never know what can happen. Mayhew, though, taking it on in for the win, followed by Nagasako, Turner, and Racine.
Yeah, definitely nice to see Bodie Turner go through. It's been a bit of a while since we've seen him on the World Cup scene, and it's good to have him back, and he's proved that he's been putting the work in by getting through that particular round. Of the eighth finals, the last of these, Corbin Girard, Michael Byers, Jeremy Rencarel, Vincent Pelloard, the return of Bodie Turner, Jimmy Thirkelsen, Corey Taylor, and Niek Kimmen of the Netherlands.
Keep an eye on Michael Byers in lane two. Not known for his great starts, but he does find his way to the front.
Yeah, he's got skills, got track speed as well.
Yes.
Last of the eight finals, and Byers has been sandwiched by the two French riders, so he's going to have to bring those skills to the fore if he wants to get through. Bodie Turner is in a top four position at the moment. Will the streak continue for the Aussie flyer? But it's Niek Kimmen leading it out. Kimmen, Rencarel going one and two. Turner's up into three and going well. Looks like Pelloard in there in four, doing it for Colombia. All move being made. Shiraz worked his way now into the top four. Kimmen leading it out. The round one winner in control of this one. Jeremy Rencarel right there. Bodie Turner's having a great lap. He's pushing for a second spot. Is he going to get it? He's going to go through, though. Turner's going to go through in that third. Girard in four. Rencarel and Kimmen going one and two.
That was a hard one.
That was a hard one.
That was a hard one. Great ride by Bodie Turner and Girard. Rencarel, Kimmen, respectively. They are your official. Looking up to the hill, we see the elite men. Heat number one, Graf, Kennedy, Andre, Turner, Pillard, and Arboleda. Six up, only four to go. At this point, all the races are stacked. Turner not off to one of his best starts, so the eyes are going to be on him. Kennedy looks like he's making his way into second place, staying patient and calm. Andre Turner diving on Andre. Andre diving on Pillard. Looks like Turner's in fourth. Pillard off the track. Graf, meanwhile, in front. Graf, Kennedy, Andre, one, two, and three. Looks like Bodie Turner's found his way into fourth, but he's not out of the woods as the Colombian is chasing him down, heading into the last straightaway. So it is not over till it's over. Arboleda railing that last corner, but it's going to be Graf, Kennedy, Andre, and Turner, and the crowd going moderately wild for
moderately
it.
Wild. We like it when it's moderately wild. Arthur Pillard just going off track on that second straight. Not the way he wanted to end his weekend, but it has been a stellar one for him. He's put some great laps in. And on the 747, returning to the World Cup scene, the crowd will go wild for Bodie Turner. Next up on the three, the world champion in 2018 at Baku, always smiling, always joking, and always fast, Sylvain Andre. And in lane number one on the seven, on his retirement tour, but certainly doesn't ride like he's retired, that is David Graf. Elite men semi number one, ready to go.
Semi-finals, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get ready for the magic.
Well, I don't know about you, Jason. My heart rate's definitely gone up a little bit. Let's see. Here we go. Here we go, elite semi-final number one is underway. Let's have a look who's going to charge down that first straight. And Anthony Dean of Australia has got a flyer. Nick Kimmon right there behind him. Graf's working his way into three. Andre in four. And Corbin Chiral's back there in five. But it's all about Australia. Anthony Dean out front. Graf's right there with him. Nick Kimmon's been shuffled back. Looks like he's going to lose a position.
Yeah, Dean out like a cannon. Nick Kimmon in trouble. Andre finding his way into third. Now going into second. Graf might be in trouble. Chiral in trouble because the Magician's making a move like he always does in the corner. So it's going to be Dean, Andre, Graf, and Ramirez, I believe, upsetting Kimmon and Shira.
Wow, I think I need a moment to catch my breath, Jason, in that one, just to try and work out what went on.